Hi, welcome back. Today I'm going to share with you about this beetle, okay? Beetles can be annoying and they can eat the leaf. Not only roses. I know many people knew that beetle love roses and cherry as well. And of course, persimmons too. So if you have a persimmon tree and you have beetle in there, then you have to pick it up, okay? Because beetles could be destroy your tree. But our persimmon tree is quite big. So if we lose a couple few leaf, which is not really harmful. Suppose you just grow your persimmon tree is still small, then you got to watch out because they could be finish up all your leaf and then eventually your persimmon will die, okay? So this is a video to share with you the beetles, how the beetles, you know, eating all those leaf. They even eat my cherry leaf. As you can see, the leaf is just like all disappear, okay? You can see all the leaf, they eat it and only left out the leaf bone, okay? And the best way to do, of course, if you dare, you can just use a bottle. I don't pick up, but my husband did. And he seems like a professional, and then he just pick up by the bottle all the time. And the suggestion is beetles during the time, during the daytime, is quite active. So if you pick up, they will fly away. But the best time to pick up is later afternoon, okay? They like to mate. As you can see, nothing can stop them, okay? Even heavy rain, they're still mating. So the best time to pick it up is during afternoon, and they're already like that tired, so you can easily pick it up. As you can see, how my husband pick up, and he's quite professional. He pick up bottles of beetles, okay? Which is gross, okay? So in this case, I just want to share with you, the minute we goes into like June, July, beetle is gonna come out, plenty of it, okay? So you just pay attention to your tree and make sure, just pick up by the bottle, okay? So I hope this sharing will help you. I'll see you soon again. Bye-bye now.好了，今天跟你们分享，你看夏天一来哈，我们这边在北卡很多甲虫，是我另外一个邻居隔壁，他家就像那个森林一样，一大堆草都没有剪的，所以呢，每年夏天我都在那个跟这个甲虫，我老公啦，在跟甲虫打仗，所以天天。 就看着他拿着一瓶那个空瓶子，他已经很厉害了，他可以把空瓶子把那个甲虫放进去里面，所以你看看多么多的那个甲虫啊，那甲虫呢当然不会伤害我的那个柿子，可是呢它会一直猛吃那个叶子，那叶子一吃的话，久而久之就会死掉那个叶子就烂掉。 所以呢，他每次看到甲虫，他就把那个瓶子给他拿起来，因为甲虫他们现在是出来的时候是最多的，等到过一阵子哈，大概好像七八月的时候吧，大概我想还是七月左右，大概甲虫就没有了，所以那时候就没有问题了。所以这些甲虫都是伤害我很，我那个他不只喜欢吃那个。 柿子的叶，它还喜欢吃那个。我们种的樱桃还没有长出来，樱桃它还是蛮喜欢吃那个樱桃的叶，所以吃的每次都每年都是在抓那个甲虫，更不用讲我的那个一棵玫瑰花，本来是长得非常好，又很香。现在每年都给甲虫一出来就给它吃光光了，所以现在看看明年是不是要搬到别的地方，我也不知道。反正我觉得很可惜，那玫瑰花到处每年都给甲虫吃，所以呢，柿子的话，它还是会吃它的叶子，我们也没有喷那种杀虫剂，因为对那个吃的东西不好嘛，所以它每次都是用。 用那个瓶子抓，而且还蛮好像它已经很习惯抓了，还蛮容易。因为你不要就说抓的时候要傍晚一点抓，太早的话它会飞走，它傍晚的话它就在那边 他就是在那边两一男一女嘛，所以他就在那边黏在那边就不动，所以比较容易抓他。嗯，所以这些就是想跟你讲啊，我们跟你分享，就是用你也可以用瓶子试试看，把它那个一碰就掉在瓶子里面了啊。好了，今天就跟你分享到这边，我们以后再继续拜拜。Shake, shake, shake. Ew! Eek! Okay.